We're back. That's a 360, baby.
It's a big box.
People love a big box. And in this big box is a new monitor from Dell, which apparently is, hold on, let me look at my notes, the world's first 40-inch ultra-wide curved 5K 2K monitor. Now, when you see a statement like that, you can be pretty sure it's not the world's first anything. That's too many qualifiers. And if the marketing department was just trying to tell you as much about the monitor as they could in one sentence, then they kind of screwed up the whole concept of world's first. So bad marketing either way, but it could still be a great monitor. So let's check it out. Right after I get in this box using my trusty shears that I keep in my pocket. Oh God. This is like a giant briefcase. This is a fun kind of thing to unbox. In it, we have a calibration report. This is showing us that in sRGB mode, which is like regular web kind of color space, the delta E's, which is the difference between what the color shows and what like the perfect color is, those delta E's are very low, which is awesome. They're actually below a delta E of one. A delta E of like 2 and 3 is like what the human eye can even discern. So that's very good. However, this is a monitor marketed towards color professionals. So if you're doing graphic design or other color critical work, you're probably not gonna be working in sRGB all the time. You might be in something like Adobe RGB or DCI P3, which they also have here, but the performance isn't as good. It's still just barely over 2. It's all under 3. So that's pretty good. We have a, how do you say, I don't want to say nonverbal, but one of those instruction manuals that's all pictures. Those can be hit and miss. I'm gonna try not to look at that. Cables, DisplayPort cable, probably gonna use that. This is a USB, I believe that's type B, like uplink cable. So that's because at the back of this monitor, there's gonna be a USB hub. You can plug lots of stuff in. And then from the monitor to the PC, you'll have this cord. HDMI, we're gonna look closely at this. You probably don't wanna use HDMI with this monitor if it's anything like other 5K, 2K monitors I've seen in the past. And then there is a Thunderbolt, actually a Thunderbolt 3 cable. These things are pretty expensive, or at least they used to be. So pretty nice for them to include, what is that, like a 4 or 5 foot cable? Nice, USB Type-C. So you can also do DisplayPort. You could run DisplayPort over USB Type-C using this cable, nice. Wow, there's a bunch of numbers on this thing. Can you see this? Here, look at this upside down one. One is the base of the monitor stand. Cool, I like this type of base. I prefer this to having like legs that jut out because you can just put your phone or wallet on it. I think that's cool. This is not too big either. Heft. Now here's the little two in the two bucket. Guess what? It's the neck. And you can kind of see already, this is a more professional executive look, as opposed to like a gamer look. Is this integrated? Toolless? Yes. Yes it is. Snap that on there and then just give this a twist with the fingers. Cool, and yeah, I can see there is a cable management channel. I like that stand, feels robust. It's like anodized aluminum. That's good. Power cable, no power brick yet. Hopefully it's integrated into this monitor. It's a very large monitor, so I would kind of expect the power brick to be integrated into there. And now I get to take this whole thing out. Oh, I think this is telling me to leave this on until later. What is this trying to say? Oh. Okay, okay, I dig it. Now I can get rid of this. We're back. That's a 360, baby. I think I can actually assemble this without having to take the shroud off. This is actually so nice. So many times, especially with a really big TV, it can be difficult to get it out of the box, but then have to lay the whole thing down on its face while you get the legs on it. And then you're looking for something soft you can safely lay it on, putting a blanket down, big pain in the butt that you don't have to mess with this time because they thought of everything. That's great. Now I just go like this. There's actually foam in there. Oh, there was more on this side too that I didn't even get to see. It's pretty heavy with the stand. It's about 20 and a half pounds. Not like unruly. Okay. We have this much elevation. Oh, it goes really nice and low. That's cool. That high. It actually has built-in swivel quite a bit. That's nice. And for tilt, you get what, the standard? Yeah, like 20. Oh, actually it tilts up pretty high. Any rotation? What? A little bit. I mean, no one is gonna use this in vertical mode. The reason that rotation is nice is that it's easier to plug stuff in, but you couldn't even turn this sideways if you wanted because it would have to be so much higher. So this is reasonable. It's nice that they give you a little bit, you know, if your table is not level or something like that. This has a really clean look, this button over here. It's just a nice little dimple for the power button and a really premium looking and feeling joystick. It looks like they want Apple users to use this. I can't wait to explore the OSD. Okay, and then looking at the I.O., I like the I.O. labels here. This is almost like a soft touch kind of plastic here. Power cord goes in there, HDMI 1 and 2. Again, I wouldn't use those. They are HDMI 2.0, not 2.1. And at this point in 2021, if you're spending $2,100, I almost feel like that's almost right there I wouldn't buy this monitor. Because in a couple months, it's just everything's gonna be 2.1, or it should be. So I don't know, let's just put an asterisk on that and keep going. DisplayPort 1.4. Ooh, here you go. This is the integrated USB hub. You can see they actually, it shows a picture of a laptop with a lightning bolt and it says 90 watts. Yeah, we have an RJ45 jack for the internet. We have a 3.5 millimeter audio jack. I believe there are four USB type A ports that are 10 gig on this thing. Oh, and here it is, down here. There's another USB type C down there too. That's really cool. Especially if you want to hook up like your SD card reader or something like that. Yeah, this is kind of a weird screen because it's a 21:9 screen, just normal ultra wide, but it's 40 inches, whereas most are 34 inches. I have a super ultra wide, which is 49 inches at my desk. So it's wider than that, but I don't know. Of course, this is higher resolution. This is 5120 by 2160. So 2160p is 4K. You can think of this as just being like the resolution of a 4K monitor, but then you have like an extra third. So it's like a 4K ultra wide, but they call it 5K 2K, which is annoying. But the reason I was picking on them for saying, this is the world's first curved, fuck this. This is not the first 5K 2K. There have been other monitors. We reviewed an LG one back in November of 2018 on Linus Tech Tips that had this same resolution, except at 34 inches. And you can buy that one now for about $1,400 or $1,500. So I don't know why you would buy this now, to be honest. But we're gonna plug it in and check it out anyway. But before we plug it in, here's a message from our sponsor, Yeelight. Yeelight's M2 smart bulbs offer seamless integration with Google Assistant as well as customizable colors for different scenes. For current Yeelight users, you can enter for a chance to win a mystery box valued at $300 with the latest Google Nest Hub and Yeelight smart lights included. If you're not currently using Yeelights, you can still enter for a chance at winning a $109 value mystery box. Check out the giveaway link in the video description. The giveaway ends on January 31st, 2021. So go! All right, this is like a little tutorial teaching you how to use the OSD and some initial setup, kind of like what you do on a TV, but you don't normally do on a monitor. The first option I have here is to enable always-on USB-C charging, other USB charging, and uniformity compensation, all of which will increase power consumption if you wanted to adhere to the ENERGY STAR rating that it has. You have to keep those off. All right, this is not really a gaming monitor. It's a 60 hertz monitor. They do claim to have a 5 millisecond pixel response time as this is an IPS panel, but for that you need to put it into like its fast mode, which means you might get some overdrive. This is, however, not a review. I'm just here to tell you that it does have like a matte kind of finish on it, 3H. Also, one thing you should know, it's curved. It has a 2500R curvature, which is not a very aggressive curve. Other monitors that are more gamer oriented will have 1800R or a 1000R curve. Let's go into the NVIDIA control panel where we can see, yeah, it's 5120 by 2160 native, and it is, I believe this is a 10-bit panel. Yep, bunk. No FRC malarkey. Let's try to put it at 75 and see what happens. This is not representative, like it's kind of a bit of a lottery. 75, it worked, cool. That doesn't mean that yours is gonna work. It kind of varies by monitor a bit. But I mean, better than 60. One thing I wanna know though is, if I switch to HDMI, will I be able to hit the full resolution? Because when I used that LG 2 years ago, that didn't work. Okay, well it's full screen, that's good news, because when I messed around with the LG before, it was actually squishing it to 16:9. But the recommended is not full res. But can it do it? It does. 5120 by 2160. Okay, well that's great news. That is fantastic. Okay, 30 hertz, Ah, there it is, guys. Oh yeah, now that I'm moving the mouse around, it's like a slideshow. Maybe, let's see what happens if I go down to 422 chroma subsampling and 8-bit. Yeah, use DisplayPort. Pretty lame. And I mean, it's not like there's display stream compression. If you had a newer graphics card, like a 30 series, you could use DSC to get higher specs than HDMI will allow, but you don't have HDMI 2.1 on the monitor, so that is totally irrelevant. So yeah, you're gonna wanna use DisplayPort. Other things about this monitor, it does have speakers included, 2 9-watt speakers. It also has a built-in KVM for switching, including picture by picture and picture by picture. So should you buy this monitor if you're a content creator? I don't know. I mean, for HDR, if you're an HDR content creator or even consumer or gamer, pass on this because it's not HDR. The peak brightness is only 300. Even the LG that was over 2 years old at this point, that had they said display HDR certification of 600, which still isn't great. You want 1,000, but it's better than 300. And yeah, the LG is smaller. This is a 40 inch. The other one I think was 34 inches, but that means that it has a higher pixel density. So pick your poison there. I just think that if you're gonna be saving $600, then I would go for the one that's already been out for a long time. Like this is coming out now, but it offers nothing new. It doesn't have HDMI 2.1. It does have power delivery, which is kind of nice. It's not a new resolution. I just don't know why this is coming out now. And if it were up to me, I would just save the money and go for the LG, which also had great coverage of the DCI P3 color space and also had good color accuracy. It basically does everything this thing can do. So I mean, this isn't a review, but my gut feeling is that I wouldn't get this one over the LG that already exists. So thanks for watching Short Circuit, guys. If you like this video, hit like and subscribe. And see us next time where we unbox a kitten. 2021 kittens are gonna be fire. That's what I heard at CES.